How's practice today?
It was good. Some minor things that we got to tweak, but you know, you're not going to play the football game perfect. You're not going to practice perfect, you know, but you know, there's always things to improve. And, you know, you got those things, you know, coach is going to do that thing, coach us, and we just got to take the coach and bring it on tomorrow.
You guys have gotten to the quarterback 15 times the last 2 weeks. What's been so different about this defensive line lately and getting home?
Just consistency. You know, we're always told that you have to earn the right to rush the passer, rush the quarterback, and that's something that we've done in the past 2 weeks. You know, we earned the right to rush the quarterback, and we haven't done nothing outside the framework, no special games, nothing like that. No, we just took the culture and then just applied it to the field.
What were you guys happier about, the 8 sacks or the 0 rushing yards that Syracuse had last week?
We were happy about a game that we wanted and that we were in due of. You know, we call that a dominant game. We were in due of a dominant game. You know, we're not happy about one thing about the other. No, it was a dominant game as a whole.
I believe this is the first time we've talked to you since after the Rutgers game. Mm-hmm. You gave us that quote about resilience.
Yeah.
You guys have won your last 3 home games in the ACC. You're sitting at 4-4. You got a big opportunity on Saturday. Speak to this team's resilience and just what the team's been like the last couple weeks to be around.
Oh. It's the same thing, like I said, during Rutgers. You know, it shouldn't be a surprise to anyone. You know, as for me that walk these halls, walk the walls of the facility, that play on the same grass as the guys that I play with, I seen it. You know, as early, before the season even started, I see how resilient, how tough, how smart, you know, how intelligent this team was. You know, it shouldn't be a surprise to anybody that we're at the position we are in. You know, we deserve to be in this position. And that's literally from our effort and our attention to details.
How fun have the past few weeks been?
Very fun. You know, one of our keys to success is have fun with your brothers. And I believe the past few weeks, we've been having fun with each other, you know, on all three phases of the football game. You know, special teams, defense, offense, we have been having fun.
He's got the lunch pail. What have you seen out of him lately?
You know, he's been... I was surprised when I carried it. I was surprised I got it before him. You know, I've always thought that it would have been him, you know, because in a way that, you know, he played, we came in at the same time, you know, 2019, and he played, you know, and I looked at guys like Jerry Hewitt, Mario, Norrell, and the guys that played in front of me, how can I be a part of this, you know, where I'm at right now, you know, and it comes from just his leadership and his competitive excellence. You know, he's been the most consistent guy, you know, and even when he feels down within himself, you know, he still practices at a high level, you know, and he deserves to carry that lunch pail.
When you look at this Louisville offense, it's predicated on running the ball. And
yeah.
Offensive line, and you know Brian Hudson well, they finish blocks. What's going to be a key against them?
It's stop the run. You know, every week you have to stop the run. Regardless who you play, you know, they have you either run the ball or pass the ball. And everything that we are taught to is run the ball. I mean, stop the run. You know, you have, like, that goes in with earning the right to rush the passer. You know, they're not going to let you throw, they're not going to throw the ball every play. You know, they got to run the ball sometimes. And we have to stop the run and minimize the explosive plays that come from the running game.
These last few weeks, you guys have done that. What is been the key to that? What's impressed you the most about the way you guys have gone about that?
Our attention to details, you know, which is our get off or our fundamentals. You know, we added hands, eyes, and feet. Every play in the playbook that we have on the defensive side starts with our hands, eyes, and feet, you know, and the coaches have done a nice job these past few weeks on honing in on those three details, your hands, eyes, and feet. And the past few weeks, everybody's been trying to get better at the hands, eyes, and feet. You know, if my hands was good yesterday, all right, let me go on to the feet. My feet good today, let me go on to the eyes, you know? So it all comes down to attention to detail.
So you guys had 8 sacks total as a defense on Thursday night. All of them came from the defensive line. How rewarding is that? What is that like knowing that you kind of wreaked havoc on Thursday night? You guys kind of all did your job.
Goes back to what I said before. You know, we were in due of a dominant game. You know, we wasn't surprised that we had 8 sacks or that we pressured the quarterback as we did. It's something that we knew that we could do. We just had to put it on display. You know, we wasn't surprised about that. You know, so it was just, it felt good, you know, to actually do it, you know, but we wasn't surprised at all.
Has anything surprised you about APR, the way he's played this year?
Nothing surprised me. So when he first got here, I'll tell a funny story real quick. He first got here, he needed a ride, and I was the first one to say, yo, I got you. And we were just talking back and forth, like, man, I'm about to do this, I'm about to do that. And he's doing it, you know, he's doing it. You know, he's doing what he preached to me, you know, and his effort, the way he practices, everything that he does in the game and in the practice affects everybody, you know, in a good way. You know, we want to do what we're supposed to coach to do, you know, but all that comes from just extra effort, you know, and that's everything that he's been given is extra effort, you know, and that just gives everybody else, all right, man, let's go ahead, let's do this thing, you know, so nothing surprising, you know, he's just doing what he told me that he was going to do.
Big energy guy?
I'll say, on practice, you could get him out, you know, like, you can tell when he's, like, having that juice or that little swag to him, you know, but sometimes, you know, you won't hear a word from him, you know, but that's just him locking in.